Now I'm on my way to the Gulf state of Bahrain, where I've heard the protests were just as bloody. In fact, more people were killed there than Egypt, relative to the size of the population. But there was no revolution, and I want to find out why. Bahrain is a small island off the coast of Saudi Arabia, nearly the same size as the Isle of Man.
Bahrain could not be more different to Cairo and Egypt. The buildings are tall and they look really, really modern. I can't even believe how different it is and how quiet.
Like most of the Gulf, Bahrain is a wealthy country, rich from oil and a haven for offshore banking. On average, the people here are four times richer than Egyptians. It's also a tourist paradise. Like us, it has a royal family, but unlike us, their royal family run the country. Looking around, it's not immediately clear why anyone would want to protest here, but I'm going to find out from Nada Dhaif.
You have a lovely car!
Who are the dudes in these pictures?
The Crown Prince, the King and the Prime Minister.
But they're everywhere! Their pictures are everywhere! Has it always been like this?
Yeah, it's always been like this, because it's getting worse.
Who controls the army?
The Minister of Defense, which is their cousin.
So the cousin controls the army, the son oversees the army, the uncle is the prime minister, and the dad is the king.
You can ask about the media as well. Same
I'm
answer.
I'm gonna guess it's a cousin.
Yay!
Am I right?
Do you know the prime minister has been serving for 42 years?
Is he popular?
Why do you think people protest? We're very close to the Pearl Roundabout.
What happened there?
Back in February 14th, people gathered here by thousands and thousands, more than 500,000.
That's half the country.
That's half the country out, calling for reforms and calling for democracy.
Nada was there too, helping out in the medical tent. I want to know more, but we've arrived at her home. She's married to a wealthy property developer and lives on one of Bahrain's most sought-after islands.
Wow.
Her two daughters are waiting for me.
Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Lulua.
Lulua, hi. And what's your name?
Alia.
Alia, hi. So, tell me, do you know what's been happening in Bahrain recently? What did mommy do?
If I say that, I will go to jail.
Why will you go to jail?
Why will you go to jail, really? Okay, first, mama was a dentist. She went on TV and she was helping people over there in the roundabout. People died, I mean were killed. My auntie came home and she said that my mama, she's gonna stay in Finland for a very long time. Every time I talked to my mother on the phone, I was crying.
Aww, yeah. Honey. So if you could change something about Bahrain, what would you change?
I would change the government and I would change everything.
But
not me. Please, not me. I love my life. I love it. Thank you.
You want to sing her a Christmas song in
French? No!
Yes. Come on, you know that time they were talking about?
Hey.
It was the time when I was arrested.
Why? What happened?
They crushed the people, the protest and the roundabout. They burned all the tents. And they started targeting everybody who helped the protesters. I was among the group of doctors who helped in setting up the medical tent at the little roundabout. In order to punish me for that, they came here in my house, 3 a.m. in the morning, and they took me away to an unknown location. And I was there for almost 50 days.
Oh my God.
I was in the room talking to my kids. That was a friend of mine,
calling them via Skype every day, pretending she was me.
Oh my God, I had absolutely no idea.
Why are you crying?
Because something came into my eyes.
What?
One of my my eyelashes came in. What?
They didn't know.
They thought I was in Finland. That's what their father and their auntie told them.
I don't believe it.
Everybody who showed up and tried to help and make change was punished badly. We were over 200 medical personnel who were arrested.
What did they do to you when you were in there? What? I don't know if you want to talk about it, but...
Can I have some tea first?
Of course you can have whatever you want.
Would you like some tea?
I would love some tea, please. That would be lovely. Oh, Jesus Christ.
I've asked Nada to start from the beginning.
So I'm going to show you now how the Pearl Roundabout looked like.
Wow, that is a lot of people.
You were there from day one.
Yeah. Oh, the first day I went with my heels and, you know, my bag, and I showed up, tick, 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 but I found it really difficult to walk on the grass, and so, okay, I decided, okay.
So you were like, you were like the protest Arab Barbie.
Yeah, they used to call me Barbie there.
I'm not surprised, Nada. I'm not surprised at all.
But really, I mean, it was amazing. You could see lots of kids sitting and coloring the balloons with the flag of Bahrain. A carnival for freedom.
The protesters were calling for the royal family to give up power and allow free and fair elections. And the Pearl Roundabout became a symbol of resistance. After 3 days of peaceful protests, the state ordered a brutal crackdown.
See, this is the army, what they're doing to people. When they crush down. This is the army. See how they're hitting the protesters and
The protests continued for weeks with an ever more brutal response.
They fired on them. This is actually in Bahrain. See what they're doing to people. This guy died instantly.
Just shocking.
The government said it was acting in self-defense and had urged protesters to exercise self-restraint. But more than 200 medics were arrested and 20 jailed. They say simply for helping to treat injured protesters. Nada was one of them.
The first 22 days, I was kept in a solitary confinement. And the severe torture took place. I was electrocuted, and they threatened me with rape.
I can't believe that they would do this to you.
And, you know, just to get rid of the torture? I said, fine, I will sign on whatever you want. Just let me go. I signed for it, that I toppled the regime. And I was sentenced for 15 years.
15 years in prison because you were there helping people as a doctor?
I'm appealing in front of the civilian court now.
What do you expect to happen?
Nothing. Another circus.
I'm amazed at Nada's courage when she still faces 15 years in prison.
You have everything. Mashallah, you know, you have children, you have a husband, you have this... I mean, what I can only describe as a mansion, but still, you went out to the streets.
Because I'm not free. I'm not free. You are not allowed to be free to talk.
Nada has been released until a new trial decides whether she goes back to jail. Looking good in court is important to show she's not defeated.
Sorry. These are your cupboards?
Some of them, yes.
These are some of your cupboards. That's the limited edition collection.
Oh, I got it from Paris.
What did you get?
Oh, shall I show it to you?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, this is sold out everywhere. Please adopt me. I thought you were supposed to be in jail. I thought you were supposed to be...
Well, yes, this is kind of my rehabilitation technique.
Hello?
If you go to prison, what's going to happen to you? You're a fashionable woman.
I have to tell you, I'll get Hermes to make a uniform for me in prison. Preferably orange. That's my favorite color. And I got this suit for the court.
Where's that?
It's a coat.
Marc Jacobs? Your bedroom is like heaven.
If I go to jail, make sure Hermes gets that done for me.
I'm on it, no matter what.
It's been good to laugh with Nada, but that doesn't mask the horror of what she's been through, with a prison sentence still hanging over her. The protests in February last year were so big that the Bahraini government asked for help from its closest neighbours. I remember seeing pictures of troops pouring across the border.
That's the crossway that links Bahrain over there behind the mist to Saudi Arabia and the rest of the Gulf states that way. And I suppose that's kind of what makes the stakes higher here. You know, if it's as though if one Gulf state falls to protests and revolution, then the others might as well. And that's a massive fear for this region.
It seems the intervention of the Gulf states did the trick. I've seen no protests on the streets of Manama. But Nada's taking me outside the capital, where she says I'll see a different picture.
I'm taking you to one of the villages. These are poor Shia villages, and there's just a huge, severe discrimination going on.
Against Shia?
Against Shia citizens and Bahrainians. Shia citizens, they were denied from employment at the army, at the Ministry of Interior.
Seriously?
Yes.
So this is to do with religion?
Mm-hmm.
Like Nada, 70% of the people in Bahrain are Shia, but the king and most of the wealthy classes are Sunni. Both are Muslim, but they're different sects. The Shia claim that they are discriminated against in jobs, housing, and all aspects of life. And these Shia villages look much poorer than the Bahrain I've seen so far.
What does the green say?
The graffiti says, "Down with the king here." They're writing things against the government. The police comes, erase it, put things against the Shia, and they go and erase it again and put something else. And it's like a ping pong. Just wait till it's evening. It's after the sunset where the rock and roll starts.
Really?
Yeah.
What do they do here? Why are they?
People go out protesting and they...
Here?
Yes, they are, here in the villages. The demonstration is still going on, but it's not in central Manama. They've taken it back to their villages.
Walking around the village of Sitra, I discover that protests have been going on here ever since they were crushed in Manama, with huge sacrifices. But the deaths and injuries haven't deterred protesters like Mohammed, who has invited me into his home.
So what did the police do to you?
Every day, police is beating every people. For me, is fighting every day and in the way.
What happened to you, to your eye?
Police is shoot in my face. He see in my eye. He don't want shot in my hand or my body.
He shot you in the eye on purpose?
Yeah, how many people kill in Sitra? Maybe now 19, 20. Only my area in Sitra. What he want, do it in Bahrain. Spit, Shia, Sunna. If me want life in Bahrain, poor. If me want another life, go out Bahrain work.
Because you're Shia?
Yeah. Don't have car, don't have work. Don't have wife. I want marriage wife. I can't.
Mohammed tells me Sitra is just one of many villages where protests are happening every day, and there are hundreds of people like him prepared to risk their lives.
I can't imagine what it's like to be them, to live that every day. I can hear the noises already, and I think the protests are starting.
I want to see for myself what happens after nightfall, so I'm sticking around.
Wow, what are you in your riot outfit? Did someone style you for the event?
I've asked Nada to join me.
I have some presents for you. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. There you go, ta-da!
Cheers, guys. Oh, gosh. I don't know how to open this.
I've been told the police are quite free with their use of tear gas, so we're preparing for the worst.
I can't breathe.
Can you get more stylish stuff than this?
I'm really sorry. This is all they had, I'm afraid. There's a lot of police. What's that? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12?
About a dozen.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm quite nervous.
I'm nervous too, but I have to see this. I have to know what it is that people are being treated like, you know?
Are you ready for so much adrenaline?
We've been told to park well away from the protest.
Okay.
I'm good. Yeah.
And make our way on foot.
Hi. We thank you. You're gonna go?
Yes.
You're gonna go to the protest?
Yes.
You're coming? Do you come every night?
Yes.
Every night?
Yes.
My legs are shaking a little bit now, I think, because I know that something's coming.
Well, actually, I've been more alive. We're back to Pearl Roundabout days.
I know.
I'm so excited.
As we walk, the crowd of protesters gets bigger and bigger.
Oh, they're joining!
They are! Look, yeah. They're all coming! Oh my god, that's so
sweet!
They're all joining! The whole town is either in this march or watching this march. The whole town is out!
When we reach the main street, I see the police lined up waiting to confront the protesters.
They're so brave! They're just going in the line of fire! They're gonna get shot!
You have to move!
It's no longer safe on the streets, and it's a scramble to find a place to hide. We're taken into one of the villagers' homes.
I can hear him. They're there. They're shooting here. There's loads. It's like a thick fog.
Put your mask on and put your goggles.
I saw that.
That's tear gas right there.
It's all flowing this way. It feels like burning, like as though you're getting singed in the nose and the throat, and I haven't even got a... It's not even properly coming around this way. The police are over there. In that corner, and they're shooting it constantly this way towards the protesters. If this was England and they were shooting tear gas like that into crowds, tomorrow's newspapers would be having a field day. Is it going to be like a massive thing, deal?
They will not mention anything about this.
The police are getting very close, and they almost spot us. They fire some tear gas our way.
It's like... Get the lights on!
All the talk of tear gas hasn't prepared me for how painful it really is.
More fuzzy drinks on your face! It's okay, but don't touch your face!
It's not safe on the roof anymore, and I'm led half blind to a room at the back of the house.
When does it take off? How long will it take?
We're not the only ones hiding out. A 15-year-old protester is also here. She's too scared to reveal her identity.
How come you're not wearing a mask?
It's fine.
You're used to this.
Yes.
And you go out every night like this. How do you go out every night like this?
Because we want our tomorrow. We want to build our tomorrow by ourselves. It's already built wrong.
Do your parents mind you coming out on the streets?
No, they never mind.
And what if you die in the streets?
They are going to be glad for that. My mother and my father will have a congratulation for that.
You're 15 years old, you're a child.
They are killing children, they are attack women. They have no rules. If it's for my country, yes. I'm ready to die.
The Bahraini government has called village protests like this one a threat to civil peace, even though the only weapon I saw was the tear gas shot at us. These protests happen nearly every day, and I'm amazed I've heard so little about them. Even more so when I discover that the most powerful navy in the world is parked right on the doorstep.
Here we have the American base right behind me, so you can see the importance of Bahrain to Americans.
If they're here, they can help the protesters.
Well, sorry to say that, but all this crap about human rights that does not work with them. It's their interests first. Bahrain has a very strategic location. You have the big two jumbo neighbors, that is Iran and Saudi Arabia. So Americans are here, you know, just to balance things. Plus,
it provides the fuel all over the world.
Bahrain holds the pipelines for the oil, and they must secure that.
I mean, they are a different country, and I understand that they're here, but is it their responsibility?
We have the American Navy. We have the most powerful people in the world, those who can make difference, those who can make change, and not to talk about it, not to interfere at this, is a crime.
When I came to Bahrain, I thought protests had been crushed and their uprising was over. But I found that revolution is very much alive here. We just don't hear about it. It's basically been silenced. While the protesters in Bahrain are still fighting for freedom, in